Hey everybody, welcome back to Blue Goose Farm. I'm Keenan McVey. I'm here with my brother Miles, and we're here with Lee Valley. It's the beginning of summer, so we're trying to get the beds harvested out so we can replant them with crops for the end of the season. We're going to show you some tips and tricks, some updates on the potatoes and the lettuce that we planted earlier in the season. And we're going to have a little harvest lunch here with some of the things that we're pulling out today, so stay tuned. So I'm just grabbing a little bit of compost so we can hill up our potatoes that we planted together about a month ago. Potatoes are growing really, really well, really strong. They're getting a lot of light right here. We planted two seeds for this one grow bag. I think it's a 10-gallon grow bag that we got from Lee Valley. The soil feels really tight. You can feel that there's a lot of roots. There's a lot of growth going on. And if you brush back just a little bit, we can see a little potato forming at the surface. And it's a little bit green at the top too. So that's what we're gonna try to avoid. We're gonna be adding a lot more compost on top so that those potatoes get covered and they don't go green, because when they're green, they can make your tummy a little bit upset. And we're also hopefully gonna get more potatoes shooting off of the stems. If you're using like a potting mix, that'll work just fine. Kind of break up any lumps, and then you're gonna wanna give it a really good water in, because these grow bags, as efficient as they are, they have really good drainage, and we wanna make sure that this plant has a sufficient amount of water. These ones we did together are looking really good, so we should have a good amount of potatoes here in about a month, so really exciting. We're here in the Little Goose now. About a month ago, we were interplanting some lettuces in with our tomato plants here. And as you can see, they've grown really, really well, and they're ready to harvest right now. Just one of those extra bonuses that I highly advise everybody to do is to plant alongside these big fruiting crops. Something like a lettuce plant isn't gonna take any energy from the soil and harm the tomato in any way. In fact, it's just gonna benefit it because it's covering the soil around it. And here we have a beautiful butter lettuce. It's super juicy. Lovely, really sweet, really tender. Really happy with how this turned out. Now we're gonna cover the soil up with some straw just to act as a mulch on top of the tomatoes. We're not gonna interplant here anymore. We're just gonna try and retain as much moisture in the ground as we can, and to try and suppress as many weeds as we possibly can while the tomatoes are finishing up. We like to grow a lot of onions. We're really big fans of onions. We're growing two types this year. This one is called Rose de Roscoff, and behind me is another one called Boratana. And they're both known for their storage capabilities, which is great. What we do in this patch, which we do in other parts of the garden, use this technique called multi-sowing, which is a really indispensable tool for us because we grow on such a small plot of land. We're just shy of a half an acre here, so we really need to squeeze in as much food as we possibly can. We use this trick for a few other crops. We use it for beets, we use it for some herbs, we use it for peas. Just in this one clump right here, you can see I have five onions growing. Now, they're not gonna get too big when they're growing side by side and that many all at once. Right now, the time is perfect. They're at a really nice size. They're really sweet and really fresh. Now we've got a really nice, fresh Roscoff onion. And we're gonna try and thin these out, each clump, over the next couple weeks to two to maybe three onions. And we're gonna leave those to harvest in late August at their full size, and then we're gonna dry them, and those will be our storage onions. So right now we have really sweet, tender onions coming out at the beginning of summer, and right before the fall we're gonna have these big, meaty, beefy, juicy storage onions that are gonna last us into the winter. So I highly advise everybody to multi-sow your crops whenever you can. What we like to do when it comes to harvesting is to disturb the soil as little as we can. If you're not used to gardening, the more common thing that you would think of is to just pull it out of the ground. But these right now, as I try and tug, this is like the sword in the stone. It's like not, it doesn't want to go anywhere. And if I do try and pull it, it's going to pull a mass of roots out of the ground, really disturb the soil, and we're going to lose all of that organic material. So all we really want to do is give a light little cut at the base of the stem, pull the fennel out, and then we're just going to be covering over this with compost, some small amendments, and then have our next crop planted in straight away. Generally want to do most of our harvesting in the morning or late in the evening when the day is at its coolest. If it's really, really hot, plants tend to crash. So we're here in our little broccoli patch right now, and we're going to talk about getting secondary harvests off crops. Something like broccoli, when you're able to take the main head out of it, you're also able to get some side shoot production, get more food out of this one little patch. So what we need to do, instead of cutting out right at the base of the plant, where we would lose that side shoot production, we're just gonna cut shallowly right underneath the head of broccoli, keeping a few leaves intact, but also making sure that we're not disrupting this side shoot area. So I'm just gonna isolate the main head here, bunch up a few of the leaves around it, and my knife goes really just right through. It's super tender. So there we have a beautiful head of broccoli. This is a ton of food here, but even out of just this one plant, we're gonna get another 3 to 4 side shoots coming out of it. After these are all gone, we're gonna be harvesting the little side shoots and be able to make little bunches of broccolini type broccoli. So the same thing would apply to garlic, where you're able to get secondary harvests. One, you're able to get green garlic at the beginning of the spring, then you're able to get garlic scapes, and then you're able to get your main harvest of garlic after. Same kind of thing with this broccoli. We're getting the main head plus the side shoots. Just another tip and trick that we use here to maximize our space and maximize the production on our small little patch of land here. All right, guys, so we got a whole lot of more harvesting to do. As you could tell, the farm is kind of demanding it of us right now, but we got to take a little break and we're going to have a little garden lunch here, eating some of the lettuces that we picked up in the Little Goose that were interplanted with the tomatoes. We got some really nice candy cane beets that we boiled up, some snow peas and some carrots. This is one of the many benefits of working in a place like this. You have really great ingredients always at your disposal and at your fingertips. It's like a little grocery store. Next time you see us, Blue Goose and Lee Valley are gonna be heading down to the city to Maddie's new spot. We're gonna be checking in with him and his chefs. We're gonna talk about the food that's coming out of the garden, hopefully cook something together. Really look forward to seeing you, so take care.